Well, howdy. I'm fixing up this bathroom, so I'm gonna paint these cabinets, then replace a light. I used a heat gun to remove this layer of paint slash sealant. I then went back and gave it several coats of paint, and that made it look a lot better. I put in some new faucets and built a mirror frame, but ultimately decided that the lighting in this room is pretty bad, so I'm gonna replace this light fixture. This vanity light is pretty scratched up, and the moisture in the bathroom caused it to rust. These bulbs use a ton of power and frequently die, so it's time to get this thing replaced. First step is to go out to your breaker, find the room, and kill the power. Now grab a screwdriver, some wire cutters, there may be some long mounting bolts, so grab a pair of pliers just in case. Also close off these drains, because if any screws fall down there, they're really hard to get out. After that, double check there's no power to the light. Now grab a ladder and take out the light bulbs. Just blew the budget on those terrible special effects, so in order to pay rent, I'm gonna now take out this screw. There may be screws like this under each one of the sockets, so take them all out. Daryl, the previous owner, decided to paint this fixture, so I'm gonna use a razor blade to serrate the edges. This will help prevent the paint from stripping when I pull it off. Once it's open, it looks like a big scary mess, but it's actually pretty simple. Each socket requires a black and white wire, which is why there's so many in there. If I disconnect these yellow caps, I'm able to remove the light from the black and white wire coming from the wall. I'll show you how to connect it later. You're gonna probably have a base plate like this, and there's gonna be long mounting screws that you'll need to remove. Most base plates are gonna be a lot smaller than this one. Now I'm pulling off the plate by pulling it forward. Wait a minute, look what the cat dragged in. We got ourselves a nice square hole in the wall. Not sure why this is there, but I'm guessing the previous owner didn't have a very good aim when putting in the light. That or some wall gnomes made a little door. To fix it, start by measuring the width and height of the hole. It's also a good idea to trim it down so it's square as possible. Here you go, little gnomes. Next, grab an old sheet of drywall and cut it out to match the hole. Next, I'm gonna grab a 1/4 inch or 1/2 inch piece of scrap wood, then slide it through the hole in the wall. This will support the new patch, so I'm gonna anchor it to the wall using 2 screws. But first, I'm gonna forget to hit record and finish the job, then take it down and do it all over again so I can show you how to do it, cause you're worth it. So you can see here, I put in the 2 screws about 1 inch away from the hole so it doesn't crack. I then used some putty to fill in the nails and screwed the filler piece to the wood. I then patched it up and gave it some texture. Now I'm ready to put up the light. I got this particular light set off Amazon and I'll have it linked below. You're gonna find that the light comes in many parts, but the piece we're looking for is a circular mounting bracket, and it's likely gonna be found under the base plate of this main light. Once you have the mounting bracket, slide it over the wires. Then you're gonna drill in holes so you can screw it to the wall. It's always best to screw it to studs, but if there's no studs available, you can use these drywall mounts to hold them in. Once the mounting bracket is up, you can now wire up the light. Strip the wire so there's 1/4 or 1/2 inch of metal, then twist the colors together, so white to white, black to black, and twist it clockwise so the caps tighten them together. You don't have to, but you can throw on some electric tape for a little extra support. This mounting bracket is circular, so I can twist it to line up the bolts to the light. I just slide it into the pre-cut holes, then use the nuts to tighten it down. Before you tighten it, double check that everything's level or in the right direction that you want. If it checks out, you're good to tighten it down. If you get the same light, you need to screw down the sockets so they're tight, then take off these rings so you can put on the glass flange. Once those are off, throw on the flange, then screw in the light bulbs, and go turn on the power to test that everything's working. And now, my friends, you have a new light fixture. As you can see, having the right lighting greatly improves the quality of most any room. If this was helpful, check out my tutorials on how to build a mirror frame and a towel rack, and all my other home repair videos. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.